What up? It's the Trooper. Yesterday, I'm actually on my way to go edit that video now, and then later on I'm gonna play poker, and it's just, the weather is just glorious today. It's drizzling rain, it's like 60 degrees, it's cool, the wind is a little heavy, but it seems to have died down, completely cloudy. I love this shit. Yo, I don't know what's going on with the weather, but it's 59 degrees out here, and with the wind it feels colder. I don't know what's going on, but I like it. Do you guys do your shits like this? You know what I mean? Like, do you do that so that people don't bang your shit? I do. Took me a lot longer to edit that Q&A video than I thought it would. 7 p.m. right now. I'm hungry. All right, so I made it down to the strip. I parked in Harris. I think I'm gonna walk to Bally's. So I just swung through the link on my way to Bally's, and Coach Greg, have you lost your damn mind? You must be crazy. I mean, what can I say? Thanks. I am gonna do what you suggested in the note. The weather's so damn nice out here, I don't even want to go inside, but there's 5 games at Bally's, and I just mentioned that to Kevin, who's a German dealer at the link, and he told me that there might be a dart tournament or something going on there. So Google just told me that there's a dart tournament going on at Bally's. This is like the middle of like a 5-day, some kind of dart tournament. Fuck, I don't know, but I would imagine dart player, like people who play darts, gamble. I don't know if the poker room is going crazy with dart throwing gamblers. I have no idea what to expect. Stop in there and grab a coffee. I don't know, why not? I mean, it's chilly out here. I like coffee. Got the coffee? Let's stop and smell the roses for like 3 minutes before we go in. I mean, it's not a rose, but it's a little bush. Actually, that's a fucking fake bush. Cheap bastards. Yeah, so I took a couple days off from poker, and not because I'm broke, or not because I don't have the passion for the game and all this kind of crazy nonsense. I mean, don't jump to such crazy conclusions just because I take a day or two off from poker. I don't know if you remember this, but before, like back in November or whatever, didn't I take like 10 days or something off from poker? Sometimes you need a break from the game. And then sometimes when you're trying to push every day and play every day, you need a couple of days off. That's it. Now I'm pretty sure there's a dart tournament going on here. Trooper who?
Trooper.
What's happening? All right, good.
Love your vlog.
Thanks a lot, I appreciate it. Can't go anywhere anymore. You know, that Wahlburgers that's supposed to be going right there, it says Wahlburgers coming soon for like a year. What the hell, Wahlburgers, where you at? I'm trying to try a Wahlburgers burger. So I've been in the game about 30 minutes. And I had to get up and tell this story because it's just unbelievable. the very second hand that I was dealt into the game, I had two red aces in the hijack. Under the Gun Plus One limped in, and I raised to $15. I bought him for $200. I made it $15 to go. The guy on my left called. The guy on his left called, and the small blind called. The small blind had $10 left behind, so we had $25 total. Under the Gun, who also, by the way, Under the Gun and Under the Gun Plus One limped. They both limped. Under the Gun called 15. Under the Gun Plus One went all in for 30. And I made it $80 with exactly 120 behind. So the guy on my left called 80. The guy on his left, who was on the button, he folded. He had called 15, but he folded. And the small blind went all in for his last 10, of course. So he's got 25 total. The Under the Gun limper, he folded. So he had called 15 and he folded. And of course the guy was already all in for 30. So the dealer gets the pots right. 25 from each player goes into the main pot. Side pot number one has $5 from three different players. And the side pot number two was just between myself and the guy on my left. So once the pots were right, the dealer burned and was dealing out the flop. And before he had a chance to turn him over, I said, time out. I'm just gonna go ahead and go all in because I can't imagine folding now, right? So I put the 120 in and the guy called. The guy on my left called before he ever saw the flop. He didn't have to call. The betting was closed pre-flop, but I made a dark $120 bet, you know, for the flop. And the reason I did it is because the way the guy on my left was calling, I knew he wasn't gonna fold, and I gave him a chance to call dark as well, which he did. So essentially, we got all the money in pre-flop. The fucking flop comes down queen jack six. I roll over my aces before the flop comes down, and the guy who was all in for $30 showed sixes. He flopped a set of sixes, and the fucking guy on my left who called dark before the flop came out, he's got $200 in the middle now without seeing anything but his hole cards, has king queen. It's queen jack six, king on the turn, and of course I say all I need is a 10, and no fucking 10 comes. It comes like a 7, I believe. So the very first hand I play, I get $200 all in pre-flop against king queen pocket sixes and an unknown hand from a guy who was all in for $25, and I fucking lose. A few hands later, I fold ace king on the turn. I bet fold ace king on a king 5-3, or king 5-7-4 board. I bet fold $40 on the turn. And then I get pocket queens on the button. I'm reloading, by the way. I get pocket queens on the button, and the lady in the cutoff raises to 15. I three bet to $30, and the kid on the other side of the table goes all in for 50. She folds, I call 20 more. I have pocket queens, he has ace jack. The ace comes right out on the flop. So I am in the game for $500, and I have $150 on the table. Oh boy, I'm not tilty or anything. I'm just can't believe that happened. I mean, obviously it can happen all the time. Obviously it has nothing to do with nothing, but it sure would be nice to book a win for a change, wouldn't it? All right, it's like 3 a.m. right now. Feels great outside, that's the only good news. I'm pretty much in the same boat that I was in when I last spoke to you. I'm stuck 380. Oh boy, I would lie if I said it's not frustrating, because at some point here we have to fucking win a pot. We have to win a hand, you know? And I don't give a fuck what you say about who's good or not good at poker. Go fucking get all in with aces and fucking lose, and you'll be stuck too. That's it. So, you know, more power to you if you never lose with aces all in preflop. Lucky you. Oh, look at this, a restroom. I need it. So I'm trying the mobile order and pay part of the app for Starbucks. So I went on the app and ordered a slow roasted ham and Swiss sandwich, paid already through the app, and now I'm going in here to pick it up. let's sit out here in the cold, eat a slow roasted ham and Swiss, and think about life. Wouldn't it be nice if I could sit down, get aces on my second hand, get it all in against king, queen, and hold up? I mean, 87% of the time, I will. All right, so the official number for the night is minus 386. The fuck can you do? You know what, sometimes it seems pre-planned. Sometimes it just seems like there's a force that is making everything go against me, which is obviously horse shit. So, I don't know. Let's walk back to the car at Harrah's and let's just look at the 3 a.m. cold outside Monday night scenery. Funny story that happened. I was sitting there in seat 9 and the guy in seat 6 got up and left the game. And then another player came into that seat. But when the player came into the seat, all I see is that he has a beer in his hand and he goes to put it in the cup holder, but the cup holder has a glass in it that's like 3/4 empty. So when he went to put it in the cup holder and there was and he couldn't put it in the cup holder, he sort of like put it down in his chair, like between his legs. So, I don't know, I just felt like being a good host to the guy. I stood up and I reached over and I took the glass and I picked it up and I put it on the empty table behind me as if to say, here, you can use the cup holder or whatever. I was just trying to be a nice guy or whatever. Turns out it was his drink or whatever. So everybody got a kind of a laugh out of it and everyone realized I was just trying to do something nice or whatever, but it's kind of a funny story. I took the guy's own drink because I thought that he, you know, it wasn't his or whatever. Maybe it's not that funny of a story, but I thought it was. Yo, remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss anything. Tell your friends about the shit so they can watch it too. And leave a comment below. I mean, I can't be in a bad mood. How can I be pissed off? How can I be upset? How can I be on tilt? There's nothing I can do about the fucking money that I lost tonight and the way I got fucking shot down left and right. Nothing I can do about it. So my life goes on. I'm gonna go home. I'm gonna go to sleep. Tomorrow is Tuesday. I'm gonna wake up and I'm gonna live my life again. I'll see you next time.